And welcome back to redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. It's Mikey here at the helm as I show you another fabulous project to work on. And this is the Spring Fling Pillow available on redheart.com. It's a free pattern and there's a link in the more information of this video to take you directly to that pattern if you want it. Now in today's video series, this is video 1 of 6. And in this series, we're gonna be working on the components of it to make it all up together. So in today's video, we have for you the basic outline of what we're gonna be doing throughout this tutorial series. You're gonna wanna watch the next part because these flowers are not done in typical manner. The flowers are actually done in rows going all the way around because we normally associate flowers to working in the center and working its way out. That's not how these work. So I wanna show you that next. And then after that, in today's tutorial, we're gonna be working on the pillow faces and you're gonna need 2 of those in order to get started on this pillow. So stay tuned and we'll be right back. So let's review the components that it takes to make this Spring Fling Pillow so that you understand how we're working with this particular project. The first thing that we're gonna do in this project is that we're gonna be making the faces for this, and these are basically just a flat panel just like so. You will notice that the stitch work is really bumpy on one side and on the other side it is more flat. So we wanna make sure that the bumpy side stays on the outside of the pillow when we're fastening everything together. So this is your working edge when it comes to making the top of this flower. The other thing that we're going to be doing is that we're going to be doing a component, and this flower is made up in different sections and this flower is not sewn into position, and I want to show you a little bit about it. So we're going to be working on the centerpiece just like so, and we're going to put some stuffing inside the centerpiece in order to make it pop. The next component is that all the flowers look like this. It's actually like a horseshoe, and what we need to do is that afterward we need to come back and just sew everything together so that it's a solid ring. This is something that I wasn't expecting in the pattern, but it's a really kind of a neat effect. So this is one size. So we have 3 different sizes of petals. So there's 1, and then we have the next one that we need to sew together as well. This is size 2. And then this is the largest size, and I've already sewn everything together just like so. So you can see that it's a gorgeous ring that happens, and then we have the flat face. So when we put everything together in the end of this project is that we're just gonna be putting it on top. We're gonna sew this down onto the face. We're gonna grab your next component that will be sewed together at this point. And there's 7 different petals on each one of these. So we just wanna make sure we're kind of rotating everything together so it looks like it's random on here, and then we're gonna sew then this little piece on. And again, we just kind of want to randomize it just like so, and then we're gonna sew on our final just like so. So it makes a really beautiful layering effect when it comes to this pillow. And all we're gonna just do then is that we're gonna use polyester stuffing to put everything together at the end, because it's very hard to find a 12-inch pillow form, and then voila, you will have your completed pillow at the end. So let's get started on working on the front face of this panel. And welcome in. We're about to do the pillow faces just like so, and you can see that this is the same design between one and the other. You will notice that this pattern has a good side and a bad side. This is the good side showing the bumps, as you can see, but on the back side it's completely flat. It doesn't have the texture like the front does. So it's one of those interesting patterns. I've decided to add on trim on the outside of this. That's not part of the pattern. It's just a single crochet, and on the corners I just did 3 single crochets onto each one as I went all the way around. This is probably the simplest part of this particular project, and it actually goes extremely fast. To help you with doing the face, I'd recommend that you have a sheet and a piece of paper and start it at number 4 and work all the way down. So go 4, 5, 6, 7 and do it just like this, because there's only 2 different lines within this pattern, but it starts around 4. So basically everything in this column is all the same stitch, and then everything in this column going all the way down. Once you get to 24, 25, put a line there, and 26 is your second last line and 27 is the final. So all I just do that when I'm working on this project is that I would just like kind of circle it at this point, then I know I'm done, and then when I do the next line I just circle it, and then when I do the second piece I come back and I actually scratch it out so I know that I've done it. So that's one of my little tips for keeping yourself organized. So let's get started. I am using Red Heart With Love today, using hot pink as my color, using a size 5.0mm crochet hook. And so the pattern is asking us for chaining of 40. Create a slip knot just like so. And remember, the first one on the hook does never counts as 1. So simply just rotate your hook and pull it through. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, and continue to do that all the way to 40. I'll meet you back up and we're gonna start our first line. So here's your first line, just like so. It's not excessively big, it's only a 12-inch pillow, and now it's asking us to single crochet in the second chain from the hook and each all the way across. So this is the first, we wanna come to the second, and we're just gonna do a single crochet in, and very quick and simple, and it's just asking you to just come along the chain and just single crochet all the way. And if you need further help on what to identify for a stitch, just kind of look carefully here. Just see that this line here is coming up in, and then this is the next one right here. So depending on how tight you are chaining, especially with newbie crocheters, they tend to be extremely tight. It's kind of harder to see. But essentially, just a single crochet all the way across this line. We'll meet back up in a second while we'll move you on to the next. This is a very quick and easy pillow face to be able to make. So I've gone all the way in a single crochet, and now I'm gonna turn my work, and now let's move up to the next row. It says chain 3, count as a double crochet. Okay, no big deal. And then we says skip the first single crochet, double crochet into next each. So essentially this is what it means. This is actually a big words for being very simple. So let's chain 3, so 1, 2, and 3. And essentially if you were to single crochet, you would come down into the same stitch where this is originating, and that's the stitch that they're asking you to skip. So in double crochet, we normally always skip over that, and we just come into the very next stitch, and we just double crochet as normal. So let's begin. So the next one, just double crochet. So let's go across this line as double crochet. This is one of two stitch work that we are gonna be doing all the way across, and it's a very no-brainer. That's what makes this pattern so quick, is that every other line just looks like this. So it's very easy and fun. So let's continue to that, to do that, double crochet all the way across. We'll meet you back up in a second and move along to the next round or next row. So I've gone all the way back across now, and now it's time to go on to row number 3. Now row number 3, so rows 2 and 3 are the repeat pattern throughout this particular project. So this double crochet will exist after we do this next row. So let's begin. It says chain 1, skip the first double crochet, counts as the first slip stitch, and then double crochet into the next. So we're just gonna chain 1, and so basically we're just skipping over this stitch here, and we're gonna double crochet into the very next one. Okay, so we're double crochet, no big deal. The next stitch, we are gonna do a slip stitch. So we're gonna come in, pull through, and through. Okay, and so the next one is a double crochet. So we're gonna do this all the way across. So double crochet, the next one is a slip stitch. Okay, double crochet, and the next one is the slip stitch. So essentially when you're looking at the bumps of the pattern, it's being caused here because what's happening is that the slip stitches are making the double crochet compress, and so this is where you'll start seeing the ridges of the bumps. So continue that, double crochet, slip stitch, double crochet, and the very last stitch will be a slip stitch into the very last one, but I'll meet you back up there in a second and we'll move along and start doing the repeat pattern for this project. Now I'm coming up to the very end, and you can always tell if you've done it right. I've just done a slip stitch, and the next one will be a double crochet in, and then the final will be a slip stitch. So you will be able to know right away if your count is off at any point, because if you have, if this is the slip stitch and then you have a double crochet at the end, you know you've done it wrong. So remember, that is just a little tip at this point. So let's turn it, and I gotta show you now, because now the bumps are really evident here, and because this only has two rows, you're gonna notice that the bumps will always stay on one side. That's why one side will always be flat for you. So let's begin, and we're gonna do the next row next. Now if you remember my instructions that we have here, we're now gonna start on row number 4, and this is where we're gonna start doing the repeat pattern. So row number 4, everything, so 4, 6, 8, all going all the way down, we'll have just the strictly the double crochet going across, and in the next row, which is number 5, we'll have double crochet and slip stitch. So this is exactly what we want to do in this pattern. So I'm gonna take you on to row number 4 now, because I need to show you, because it looks slightly different, and then you can just continue to do the double crochet slip stitch all the way until you get to row number 25. Stop there, we'll meet back up on row number 26, because this is repeating all the way. So remember, just every other row is different all the way until you get to 25. Now in this row we are just gonna do a strictly a double crochet, but it's not always easy to tell where the double crochet is because of the way that it's working. So I wanna just give you some pointers here. So we're just gonna chain up 3 as normal,
just like so. So where is the stitch work? You have to look backward in behind because the way that the slip stitch is dragging it, the double crochet, and making it bend over to away from you, that the double crochet is actually facing away from you and it's on the other side. So wrap and going in just like so. So the next double crochet is actually the slip stitch that is really tight in between these bumps. So coming in. Okay, so the next double crochet is just right on the top here and it just got to bend it forward and you will get a feel for this really quickly. It's not a big deal. And so the next one then is the really tight stitch right in between. That is the slip stitch again, and essentially it's bringing everything back in balance. So just double crochet all the way across. Just look for those little tips on where those stitch work is and go all the way. And in the next round you're just gonna start off round number 5 and just do your chain 1 and then you're just gonna do your double crochet, slip stitch, double crochet all the way across. And let's stop here at this point. I'm gonna join you back up on row number 26 as we finalize off this pillow face. And thank goodness for the miracle of the internet and being able to fast forward ahead of time, and I was able to do this off camera. So you can see that it looks really quite lovely. Nice flat side to it, nice bumpy side, and now we're starting row number 26. So 26 is just very simply, just exactly where I kind of left you off. You want to just double crochet, so chain up 3, and then just basically do exactly what you were doing already. So just double crochet yourself all the way across. And just look for the tops of the double crochet and then the slip stitch that is in between. So this is row number 26, very quick and easy. You've got your rhythm down at this point. You should be able to whip this off in no time. Let's meet back up at the end of the row and we're gonna start off with your final row, which is number 27. So row number 26 is now done. We're just gonna simply turn our work and do our final idea here, and we are just gonna chain up 1 and we are just simply gonna single crochet ourselves all the way across, and this will conclude doing the pillow face. Now when you when I just switch the camera in just a second, I am gonna show you how I did the trim work all the way around if you're interested in that. That is not part of the pattern, but I want to show you anyway because it might give you some creative influence when you're working on your spring fling pillows. So just stand by, I'll be right back and we will kick off doing some trim. So I've come all the way across. I'm just weaving in my final edge here, and we can catch that in when we're doing our sewing as well, and just kind of stretch everything back out and just make it look really pretty. So I used a white trim for my particular one, and now I want to show you how to do that. So I'm just gonna grab my white again and I'm just gonna pull it forward, and essentially I'm just gonna create a loop and I'm just gonna start off in a corner just like so. So I'm just gonna go into a corner and do a loop onto the hook like that, and then keep my straggler down on top of the line. I'm gonna chain 1, and essentially when I'm working down the sides here, this is not part of the stitch on the top, but it's the sides. You just have to make sure that you're equally spacing the stitch work in, and don't try to go into a big gap. Always try to get just a few strings only so that it's not gonna pull it apart, so you will see the gap. So you wanna go in the gap here, but you really don't, because it's gonna pull apart your work. So you're just single crocheting, you're just kinda eyeing it up when it comes to the sides, just making it very kind of fun and fabulous. You're trapping in your straggler as you go, and essentially it's just that simple, going all the way around, keeping everything a little bit tight. You will be using this particular round to sew everything together, so if you're sloppy with this particular one, it might be very noticeable. So this is something that's creative and up to you. Again, it's not part of the pattern, but it's something that you may be interested in. So when you get to the bottom, you will have stitches to be able to play with, and when you get to the other side here, you'll just have to do the same concept, and of course when you get backed up here, you'll be able to have the stitch work on the top as well. So that's just a way of creating some kind of trim when it comes to being your project all the way around. So there you have it. You just have to make 2 pillow faces just like so, and we're gonna put those together at the end of your project, and this is gonna be fun and fabulous. Now the trim that you see here, that can be done now or you can wait afterward.
This is something that I have added to the pattern. It wasn't part of the original, but it's something that you can decide for yourself. I know some viewers want to do ruffles around their pillow. Again, the creativity is up to you. In the next video, we're going to be working on the center motifs, and these are the very centerpiece that appears in your flower. And this is all one component, even though there's two different colors, don't let that fool you, it's all one flower. So join me next time as we work on the center motifs in video number 2. Welcome back to redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. I'm your host Mikey here at the helm as I show you another fabulous project. This is video number 2 of 6 on working on the spring fling pillows. So if you're just joining me now, there is one video, video number 1 ahead of this, in order to show you how to do the faces of your pillow. Today's video, we are working on the center motif, and when you look at the flower, you can see the green and a layer of the flower. That's actually one motif. It's just a color change with inside. So without further ado, let's get started on working on this pattern together. So let's get started. We are working on the center motif just like so. This is one piece here. You can see on the back that there's like a pocket that's formed. You can put stuffing on the inside of that if you want at the front to be able to pop out instead of sinking down just like so. Again, the creativity is up to you. There is a color change at some point within this pattern here, and it just carries on. So when you're looking at the pillow here, this green plus the first layer right here is all one piece. So now let's get started. I am using Red Heart with Love today for all of the ideas. This is hot pink, we have white, and then I'm going to be using candy floss, and it is fabulous. I'm using a size 5.0 millimeter crochet hook today by Susan Bates. To begin, we are going to do a slip knot just like you see here, and if you know a better way, then you're more than welcome to do so. Slide in your 5.0 millimeter or a size H crochet hook into your work, and now we are going to chain 4. So this never counts as 1, by the way. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now it's asking us to 11 double crochets in the 4th chain from the hook and join with a slip stitch at the top of chain 4. So this is your chain 4, and all it's asking you to do is go in the very beginning one. So we're just going to wrap and going into double crochet into the first one. And it says to do 11 of those. So I just basically continue to go. So when you've done the chain 4, so just continue to go while I talk to you. While you did the chain 4, that actually counts as 1 double crochet. So essentially you are doing 11 double crochets right now, but the chaining of the 4 counts as 1, making a total of 12 all the way around. For experienced crocheters that do hats, you're probably very aware of that, and that's something that newbies may not completely understand. So it's a count. So you just count by just pulling it apart. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then we do 8. I'm just catching that straggler into position there so you'll never see it. 8, and then we're going to do 9, 10, 11, and 12. So I want to recount, so you're just going to pull 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And remember what it says, you're going to join with the slip stitch. I'm just taking the straggler, just putting it in behind, and slip stitch it to the top of the chain 4 that you started off with. And there is your very center of your motif. So your next one that you have here is chain 1, 2 single crochets into the same stitch as joining, and then in each round all the way around, and then join with the slip stitch in the back loop of the first single crochet. So let's simplify. You're going to just chain 1, and this is where you've joined, okay? So you're just going to do 2 single crochets in. Okay, so we're just going in for single, and then we go to the next one for 2. So every stitch around is going to get 2 single crochets. So complete to go all the way around, and I'll meet you back up where we're going to join with the slip stitch at the back loop. I'll show you what to do with that next. So you're coming all the way back around, and very easy, 2 single crochets into each, okay, and
you have your last one here, and I can tell that this is leading into the one that we started, so that's not one that we want to go into. So we want to slip stitch it at this point, and we want to slip stitch it into the back loops. And you will notice that there's like a lines that you can see going all the way around. That's caused by going into the back loops. When you look at typical crochet, you don't ever see these kind of lines, and so that's what is happening here. So all you have to do is, like, right at the top where you have everything, you have two loops. Usually the two stitches, two lines are the one stitch. And so the loop that's closest to you is the front loop, the one that's furthest to you is the back loop. So we're essentially just gonna jump over the first loop, going into the back and pulling through and through, and voila, you've just done a back loop slip stitch join. So in round number 3, we are chaining one and then working in the back loops with the single crochet in each single crochet going all the way around, and then a join with the back loop again. So we're just gonna chain one, like this, going into the next one, and we are just going into the back loop. So let me show you. So the two that loops here, just like I explained, is one stitch. But if you go into the front one, that's the front loop. You go into the back one that's furthest to you, it's the back loop. So every stitch in the back loop is going all the way around, and you can see that the lines that you saw that I just pointed out is starting to emerge. And we're gonna go all the way around and join with the back loop join, just like I showed you just a few seconds ago, and very easy. So this is round number 3, very no-brainer. Just go all the way around, join it, and we'll meet you back up in just a second. And back all the way around, you're gonna start noticing that it's starting to take a bowl shape. It's gonna start to pucker on you, and that's what you want. So just look down and you can see where you've joined before, because sometimes you can just continually go around, because I've done that a few times already with this design. So just join the back loop only, and let's begin round number 4. And round number 4 is identical. So chain one, going into the back loop for a single crochet again all the way around. So do that, we'll meet you back up in a second. We'll complete round number 5. Okay, finishing up round number 4, again a back loop slip stitch join like that, and now let's go for round number 5, chain one, back loop only again, and this is the last time we'll be doing this particular kind of stitch at this point with this particular motif, and just continue to do that. We'll meet back up and move on to round number 6. So we're now coming back around, and we are just gonna do a slip stitch join to the back loop only. And now let's move along to round number 6. So round number 6, chain one, working in the back loop only, single crochet, SCDC, as you see, single crochet decrease 12 times. So let's begin. We're gonna chain one. And so essentially we are just working in the back loops only, so just going into the back, and we are doing a decrease stitch. So we're gonna wrap and pull through and hold that on your hook. Let's grab the next one. Going in, grab it. So now you have three in your hook and you're gonna pull it all together. So that basically has made two stitches here into one. And we're gonna continually do that. So every time you come back, so every time you see two, so grab, pull through, go into the next one, pull through, and now pull through all three. So just continue to do that. So essentially you are decreasing all the stitches by half at this point, because every two that you're running into, you're making it to one. And you will notice that this was kind of creating a pucker. And remember what I showed you in the very beginning, that this pocket that is on the inside, well, that's being caused by the stitch that we're doing right now. This is concluding everything together to give it a nice bowl shape like you see. So continue to do that. So single crochet decrease on the back loops only for this entire round, and you'll see that the pocket is starting to form. So I'm back all the way to where I started, and I'm just gonna finalize my last two. This is the wonderful thing about this pattern. If you had 14 areas here to do that instead of 12 like it asks, you know, it's really no big deal. This is a flower, it is really quite simple. So just let's fasten off. We're gonna now remove this color off of this at this point, and I'm simply just gonna trim my yarn like so, and I just wanna kinda pull it up and weave it in. I don't have to be too particular about it, because this is actually gonna be on the underside of the flower at this point. And the next one is kind of an unusual idea, that we are not starting on the edge that we just created, this whole little, you can see it's like a little bowl now. We were actually moving one stitch up higher in order to begin the next color. And so this is what it will look like then from the top down. So this is actually quite excellent at this point. For round number 7, it says to join D, which is another color, and this color is only existing for one round, and so basically in the original pillow that I did is that I never bothered to change it, but that's something that's completely up to you at this point. So it says join with a single crochet in any front loop of round number 5, single crochet in the next blah 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 blah. So let's take it one step at a time. So the last row we just finished was round number 6. So remember what we have here. These loops that you see are now the front loops of the same stitches that you see. Okay, so do you see I'm not coming on the edge, I'm coming one back, and basically I can grab it anywhere. I can just start anywhere at this point, so I'm just gonna go here because I see it a lot easier. And so I'm just gonna join D, so I just got a loop just like so. Sorry for the weight here on this particular pattern, and I'm just gonna just do this. And I chose white because there's white on my trim of my pillow. So I'm just gonna basically join and then single crochet in the front loop of any of the next 4. So let's begin. So the next 4, okay, so I'm just gonna come into the next stitch that you see here. I'm pulling everything tight and I'm just keeping that straggler on top of the line. So this is 1 out of 4. So let's just pull it back, just going to the next. This is 2. So I'm just coming into the front loop. 3. And 4. I just want to keep that straggler under control, so that was 4. So now it says single crochet in the next loop and then single crochet in the next 5. Oh sorry, single crochet 2 times in the next loop. So coming into the next loop, we're gonna do that one 2 times. So 1 and 2, and then for the next 5 we are gonna do single crochets. So continuing to just kind of peel it back like an onion so you can see your stitch work. So we got 1, 2, 3, and then 4, and then 5. So now what it's asking you to do is 2 single crochets in the next and then keep repeating that. So let's go. So 2 singles in the next, 1 and 2, and so basically the next 5 again. Okay, make sure, do you see how you're following the line all the way around? I almost jumped because this is where I joined with the slip stitch. I almost jumped and went on to the next round that's all the way around. So I just want to make sure I'm paying attention. So I'm just going to come up forward a little bit and make sure I stay on the same round. So 1, and then 2, and 3, and then 4. And 5. And the next one is gonna get 2 again. So next one is 2 single crochets. And the next 5 again are gonna be singles each. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And next one is gonna get 2 singles in. And then whatever remainder, this should actually be the very end, but you can see I probably have 1 stitch left over, no big deal. I'm just gonna fill it in with a single crochet in and then join it to where I started. And when I join, I just can join it into a regular stitch so that I don't have to do back or forward. And I'm just gonna just grab my scissors and trim that off and fasten it off and weave it in. You can see that you now have a lip that's all the way around. And we are gonna be using this white area then for your next area. This is pretty well going to just stay hidden under the flower. It will have a little bit of exposure just for a little bit of accenting color, but it's really no big deal. And in the original pillow that you saw with the green, I didn't bother to change it at that point, but that's kind of my personal choice. So trim that off nice and short so you don't have to worry about it later. And I'm going to grab my next color, which will be hot pink, and this is what it looks like at this point. So grabbing the hot pink now, we just want to go into the white section here. That is round number 7 as it's asking. It says join B with the single crochet in a back loop of round 7 and single crochet in each back loop going all the way around. So again, it's just the same here and we just want to go into a back loop at this point and just looking at it. So I've been working at it so that it's been underside just like so. So that's kind of what I want to do going forward. So I can just grab it anywhere. So as long as it's a back loop like that, we can just grab the loop of the new color and just pull it through. And I'm just gonna do, what do we have here? I'm just gonna chain 1 It doesn't ask to chain one. I'm just gonna chain one, and then in the next back loop I'm just gonna single crochet all the way around. You know, sometimes you have to improvise to what you feel most comfortable. The way that I add all my stitches sometimes is different from what a pattern can offer, and it's something that is complete personal taste just for you. So again, we're just going into the back loops only, and I'm just trapping that straggler underneath the stitches just like so. I've got enough in there, and so now basically I'm just gonna single crochet all the way around in. So the back loops here, why are they asking for that? The simple reason is that when you do only one side of the stitch, it makes it very flexible and very bendable. And so basically the petals are gonna be able to sit underneath, and this will be able to sit upward when it's sitting down on top of the pillow. So continue to single crochet, back loop only, all the way around. So I've come all the way back around, and it just says to slip stitch in as normal. It's not saying slip stitch in the back loop, it's just saying slip stitch to be able to form it around and join with the first single crochet. So that is how you do that. So let's move along. This is the final round of your project for this particular motif, and what we have now is chain one, single crochet in the first two single crochets, and then two blah 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 blah. So let's get started. Don't you love that? So chain one, and it says the next single crochet in the first two. So we're just going into the regular stitches, not anything special. So the first two is gonna get a single crochet each, and now the very next one is two double crochets into the next twice. So what's it asking for you is the next one is gonna get two double crochets just like that. So you got your first one in, and the next one is gonna be two double crochets as well. So that's what it means by twice. And then we're back onto the pattern here. It says single crochet in the next two single crochets. So the next two are just singles. Okay, and so the next two then are the double crochet again. So two double crochets into the next. And what this is doing is giving it a beautiful ruffling effect for the outside. And so that was one. And so the next one has two. And then the very next two have two single crochets each. So continue to do that same pattern all the way around. We'll meet you back up, and this is the end of this particular round, motif at this point. So now I'm all the way back around, and I just finalized the two last double crochet sections in, and it says just to simply slip stitch it to the beginning there, and that completes this round. So let's just trim our yarn at this point, and this will conclude this particular motif. Just wanna weave in the edges underneath. And I just want to do a nice job in the original that I show you. I kind of just taken the red under here, and I just kind of went underneath and just to make sure that it stays out of the way and it doesn't fall out if you're giving it to a friend. So let's move along, and thank you for joining me today. So here's the final from what we have, and as I can tell you on the first one that we had, see how I never change color, and this one we have the color change in the inside. Again, the creativity is strictly up to you at this point. So join me next time in the next video as we work on the second motif of this pattern.
So there you have it, you have your centerpiece now done, and you're now ready to move on to your next piece. In the next video, video number three, we're gonna cover the very largest motif that exists within the flower. Now you're kind of thinking to yourself, why didn't the artist go down to the very next size up from this one? And that I figured it out, that it's easier to understand the stitch work in the very largest one because the next two of these get smaller and smaller. But once you understand what she's asking for, it makes the other two a lot easier to work with. Join me in video number three as we work along the very bottom motif of this spring fling pillow. Until next time, I'm Mikey on behalf of redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. We'll see ya. And welcome back to redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. I'm your host Mikey here at the helm as we show you another crochet tutorial. In today's project, this is video number 3 of 6, and in today's video, we are still working on the spring fling pillow, but we're working on the motif that exists right at the very bottom of the flower, and we're doing that one next. Now, you'll understand that the next two that are above it are a bit smaller, but it's a lot easier to understand this pattern by working on the largest one first. And now when you're working on it, just like so, here is another motif that I've been working on, and you can see the trim work. You can change colors at any point that you want in order to really make it customized for you. So let's get started on working on this fabulous tutorial together. Welcome back. We are about to start this motif, and this is the largest one of them all. This one takes the longest of them because it is the biggest. Very simple, but the interesting thing about this flower that caught me off guard and is catching a lot of people off guard is that the flower does not work from the center out. It's hollowed out. And when we're working on this, we're actually working as if it's patio lanterns, just like so, like they're kind of dangling. And basically we want to work, and if you look at the petals, just like so, the lines or the rows are going straight across, and you can see that here as well. They're just coming straight down, and essentially we are just doing one after another, and then this whole interior that you see that is joining it and making it thick is actually done afterward, and then essentially at the end we are just going to sew everything together so that it's forming the perfect ring. So it's one of those that's actually really kind of confusing for many people, because they don't realize that the petals are not being constructed from the inside going out, but they're in actual fact they're being constructed just like you see here, like patio lanterns hanging down. And at the end, we just sew it together after we've done the center part, and voila, you are good to go. So when we're starting off, everything looks just like so. And essentially what's gonna happen is that we are just gonna crochet, boop, 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 come, and then come to the next one, boop, 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 boop. And basically we keep doing that until we get 7 petals all in a row. All of these have only 7 petals, and they're all constructed in the same manner. Now I put these white strings in here to really give you an indication, because we have rows 1 to 7 just inside one petal. Now the first one here, this is row number 3. The middle section of the petal is row number 4, and then we have row number 5 on the outside. But essentially from the middle to this side is identical from the middle to the other side. And once you understand that, you can start seeing that there's a relationship here, and this exists within all the different petals that we have. So let's begin. We are gonna start off, and essentially again, it's just starting off, and we're just gonna do petal by petal. I'm gonna do the first 2 petals for you, and then you can reverse the video if you need to, and then stop at when you get to 7, and then we're gonna pick up from there, and we're gonna fill out the middle part just like you see here, because that's all done afterward. If you're confused at any point in this video, please stop it and just kind of reflect. It is really not that hard, but I may go a little bit fast because I've been learning how to do these, and they're really quite simple. So let's start off with a slip stitch just like so. Slip it onto your needle and our hook, and we have chain 7. So this never counts as 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So this essentially here, when you're looking at the original pattern as we're working all the way across, this is actually 7 working along the bottom here of the petal. Okay, so it's not never the bottom, it's always the sides. And once you get that through your head, you can actually make a lot of sense of this. So round number 1, this is row number 1, we are just gonna single crochet 2nd from the hook. And we're gonna single crochet all the way back to where you started. Now if you remember, we just skipped over 1 stitch in order to make this happen, so you will essentially have 6 single crochets left by the time you get to the other side. And that's important, because it's something that you just have to keep in the back of your brain for when you're doing the reciprocal idea for this stitch. So we just finish off, and voila, very simple. We're now gonna turn the work just like so, and we are gonna chain 1. Now this one here, we are gonna single crochet into the first 5, and then the last one, which is number 6, you're gonna do 2 single crochets. So coming straight down underneath, just like there, just single crochet, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
So you can see we still have one more stitch to go, and in that stitch we want to do two single crochets, and this is what's going to make the flower starting to have a rounded shape, because you've just added an extra stitch. So you can just see it's coming around and starting to form a little bit of a lip going around. So let's turn your work at this point, and we're moving up to row number 3. And in row number 3 it says chain 2, and this doesn't count as a half double crochet. So just chain 2, bear with me for a second. So right underneath where you came out of is where you want to put in your first 2 half double crochets. So wrap and through, pull through, pull through all 3 on the hook. So that was 1, and do that again. Same stitch right underneath, and essentially you were growing the petal out to be more rounded. Now the very next 2 are going to be half double crochets. So the next 2 are half doubles. And then the final that we have is that we have single crochet. So there will be 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now we're moving on to row number 4. So let's turn the material again, and in row number 4, as I mentioned before, that's the halfway point. So let's chain 1, and we're going to single crochet into the first 4 single crochets. So this is 2, 3, and 4. So now the final 4 stitches here are going to be half double crochets, and this is your halfway point. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that was your half. That's your exact center of your petal right here. So let's turn the material and move up to row number 5. And in row number 5 it says to what's it say? It says chain 2, half decrease, and then half double in the next 2 half double. Okay, so here we go. So 1 and 2. So now we're going to start doing decreasing. So we're just going to wrap and going into the stitch that is right underneath and pull through. So you will have 3 on your hook. Wrap, going into the very next one, pull through, and now you'll have 5 on your hook. And so you're going to grab the yarn and pull it through all 5, and that was a half double decrease. The next 2 are just going to be regular half doubles. Okay, and the next 4 are going to be single crochets. So essentially, if you remember then on row number 3, you know how we did the increase right here? We have 1 and 2, they're increasing. This here is making it decrease on the other side. So we're now going to turn our work, and we're just going to chain 1, and we're going to single crochet in the first 5 only. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And in the next, we're going to do a single crochet decrease. So we're just going to go in, pull through, go into the very next one, pull through all 3. So we're now going to turn it, and we're just going to simply just chain up 1. And now we only have 6 single crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And this completes doing 1 petal. So you can see that the petal is done, and you can see there it is. So you know that it's done right. So how do we do the next one? Very simply, we're going to do that next. Okay, so in row number 7, we had a lot of instructions here, and I'm going to simplify it for you. All I need you to do is that we need to chain 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And essentially what the directions are telling you is go back on the directions to row number 2 and do row number 2 all the way to 7 one more time. And this here, when you chain this, this is actually the next one that's leaning over. Okay, so that's not the bottom, it's underneath, and a lot of people get confused by that. So let's begin doing this petal next. So looking at the instructions for saying next row after row number 7, what we need to do is just chain up 1, and that counts as your very first one going in. So right over here, this next section right here is your very first one going in. So we're just going to do a single crochet, and we just have to get 6 into the sides of these stitches. So this is 2, you just have to eye it up, 3, 4, and it will take you all the way to the other side. So this is 6. So now what we have to do is that we just have to jump into the next petal right on the edge and just simply put in seven single crochets. The reason why there's six on here is that that chaining of one counted as one. So this is two. Just putting it in. 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And 7 should take you to the other side of the petal just like so. So again, just continue to do that and just immediately going into the next one for a single crochet. So just for 7, 1, 2. So I'm now done all the way. So I got 7 and I'm just gonna turn my work, and you can see it's been a lot more stabilized now that you've done one round. So this is the very last round or row that we have for this particular project. And so it says chain 1, single crochet into the first 5, and then single double crochet into the next, and do that 7 times. So we're just gonna chain 1 and we're just gonna do 5. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And 5. And so then the final 2 in between here will get a single double or a single decrease. So wrapping through, grab the next one, wrapping through, so you have 3. And essentially what this is doing is that it's causing it now to bend into a circle. So now let's do the next 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5, and the next one, next 2 are single double single decreases. So wrapping through, and pull through. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then decrease. So do this all the way across. You will, your last stitches will be this decrease as you get all the way to the other side, and we will catch you back up in a second. We're gonna fasten this together, and then what we're just gonna do is just finalize the edge of this particular project. So I've now come all the way across and we are officially done, but what I wanna do before I get rid of my yarn and fasten it off is that I wanna secure this into a circle. Make sure that when you're doing this at this point that it's not twisted and twirled, and all essentially I'm just gonna do is that I only wanna grab, see where this is grabbing right in the ends here? I don't wanna attach the petals so that they're attached all the way down the petals. So essentially I just wanna reach across and I just wanna use my yarn and I wanna pull it together. You can use a sewing needle if you wish to sew these together, or you can just grab your crochet hook and just kinda single crochet them or slip stitch them together. I'm just gonna slip stitch them together at this point. So it just makes it look consistent going all the way around. Grabbing my scissors, I wanna trim my edges off like this, coming in, and when I go to finish this off I wanna make sure that I'm coming back in to the work and just making sure that I'm catching everything that I possibly can catch so that you know this won't fall apart afterward, and voila, you now have an edge. So I just need a little more time to be able to perfect this edge so that they're both kind of working together with each other instead, and other than that we just gotta work on our final perimeter going all the way around. So what's left on this project at this point is the final trim, and you will notice that the edges look pretty rough. And this is the reason why we haven't gone on around our trim. So you can use either different color if you wished, or you can just use the same color, which I'm about to. And essentially we just wanna create an area here. So I'm just gonna come down right in between any of the petals. It doesn't matter where I start. I'm just gonna grab the loop and voila. And I'm gonna let the straggler just fall down. And essentially I'm gonna chain 1 and I'm simply just gonna go into every stitch that you can possibly get into on the sides of the petal. You can see the stitches there. It's the challenge of the tops of these petals and where to find the stitches. It's actually no big deal. So you just wanna make it look like it's evenly spaced if you're having a hard time with that. So essentially now I'm starting to work in just the sides here, and essentially I'm just kind of eyeing it up and making it look pretty. And I'm just going one stitch into each row as I'm going around. Now when you do this you're gonna notice that the petal is gonna lean forward, it's gonna flip forward, and that's part of the design. If you notice the little girl holding the pillow, the flower actually leans forward towards you in the camera. So now that I'm on the other side of this, I'm simply just gonna come into the stitches on the other side. And because I'm using the same color, it, you know, you can be a little bit lazy, I suppose you can say. It's when you get an opposite contrasting color that it gets really kind of confusing. So now that I'm done all the way down one petal, I simply am gonna jump to the next, and we're just gonna single crochet around just like I just showed you. And do this all the way around, and when you get back, we're just gonna slip stitch it, and voila, this entire motif is now done. And it's actually looking quite fabulous at this point. Now, as promised, all the way back around, and we just wanna slip stitch it to the beginning one that we had, like so. And we just wanna weave in our edges, and this is gonna finalize your motif for this part. And this is the biggest one of them all. This one takes the longest of them all. And once you understand the concepts here, the rest becomes so much easier because these petals get shorter and shorter as you work along your particular project. So just continue to do that, weave in the edges, and don't be scared to do anything with the colors. And voila, just trim off your loose ends. And as promised, you can see that the leaves now, or the petals now, pull forward, and that's exactly how it appears. So let's move. So there you have it. You've now finished your largest motif, and now you're ready to move along to the next motif that sits directly above this one, and that's video number 4. So join me in video number 4 as we work on the next size, and the stitch work is very similar to the idea, but there's a few less stitches to work on because the petals are smaller. So join me next time here on video number 4 on redheart.com, as well as the Crochet Crowd. Until next time, we'll see ya. Welcome back to redheart.com, as well as the Crochet Crowd. I'm your host Mikey, here at the helm as I show you another crochet tutorial. In today's tutorial, this is video number 4 of 6, and we're working on the Spring Fling Pillows by Redheart. And what we have here is that we're now working on the next motif, and if you see the green here, it's the very next one that sits directly above that, and that's what you have here. You have a beautiful ring. So in today's tutorial, we're going to be working on the next one going up, and then we just have one more to go in video number 5, and then in video number 6, we're going to assemble everything together. So without further ado, let's get started here on the Crochet Crowd and redheart.com. And welcome back. We are about to start the next motif, as you can see here, and this one will just sit right directly over the one that you just completed in the last video series that we have. So very simply, it's the same concept that we just did in the last video. These look like little patio lanterns when you're done with it, and essentially what we're gonna do, just like we did before, is that we come back along and then we fill in the center point in order to make it all stabilize, and then we add a trim afterward. So to begin this easy tutorial, now that you've done the biggest one first, you're gonna find that this one is a lot more simpler because you're starting to understand the pattern as you go. Now, just like the last video that we have, these are the same amount of width that we have in the last one. The only difference is that these are shorter, therefore there's less stitches going all the way across. Just like I showed before with the white markers here, this is row number 4, this is 3, and this is 5, and you can see that once you do one half of this, the other side becomes reciprocal. It's the same thing, and all we just need to do is that when we crochet, we're just gonna be working like this, bah, 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 and then we add the next one, and then we need a total of 7 of these in a row in order for this to continue. So let's begin this tutorial today as we start off with this particular motif. To begin, we are gonna chain up 5. We're just gonna start up a slip knot first. And so I'm gonna point out some of the differences between the last pattern and this one. And the last pattern, we actually chained 7. This one, we're only chaining 5. So let's begin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now second from the hook, we're now gonna move up here, and we're just gonna single crochet all the way back. Now because you chained up 5, we had to skip 1. Second from the hook, therefore there will only be 4 single crochets on this line by the time you get back to the end, which is what you need. Let's turn your work now at this point, and we are gonna chain up 1, and now we're just gonna go, the first 3 single are gonna be 3 single crochets. So 1, 2, and 3. So you'll have 1 stitch left on this line, and the last stitch is 2 single crochets. Does it look familiar from what you did on the last petal tutorial? Absolutely, it's the same concept going around the edge. We're now gonna turn, and we are just gonna chain 2. and we are gonna do 2 half double crochets right into the base of that. So 1 and 2. So, and then the very next one is 1 half double crochet. So the difference between the last tutorial and this one is that we did 2 half double crochets in a row. This time it's only 1, and now we are just gonna single crochet for 3 remaining on this petal. Okay, moving along, we're gonna turn, chain up 1, and now for the first 3, we are gonna do 3 single crochets. Okay, this is row number 4, and this is the absolute middle of the petal. So the next 3 are gonna be 3 half double crochets. Like so. Let's turn our work. We're gonna chain up 1 and 2, and we are gonna do a half double crochet decrease. So wrap, going into the very first one, pull through, wrap, going into the next one, pull through. You will have 5 loops on your hook. Pull through all 5. And now the first one is a half double crochet. Okay, and now the next 3 are single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. So we're just gonna turn our work here. We're gonna chain up 1, and the first 3 single crochets are gonna be single crochets right above. So 1, 2, and 3. And then the last 2 single crochets that are here, these are in the half doubles here, we're just gonna wrap them through, grab the next one, wrap through. Okay, and then pull through all 3. We're gonna turn, this is the final, so chain 1, and we only want a single crochet into the 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that is petal number 1. And basically we just have to repeat exactly what we're doing here. Let's get you onto the next petal here. And at this point, we're just gonna, this is where you're gonna come back and start doing the remainder of your petals until you have a total of 7. So just a quick review, we got our first petal done. So now essentially we're gonna chain 5, and a lot of people assume that that chain 5 is actually the bottom of the next petal, and in fact it's the actual side here, and then we just continue to work our way going up. So let's begin to do that process next. Let's just chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then second from the hook, we're gonna single crochet our way back. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So let's begin. We are just gonna chain 1, and on the first one here we just need to get 6 single crochets in. The rest of them we just have to do 7. The reason for the difference is that the chaining of 1 counts as 1. So we essentially just are coming along the tops, just come in between the rows that you can see. That was 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, and 6. So that is perfect. You just needed 6 in that first one, and that will take you right to the end. So you just wanna make sure your next petal is just not twisted. You can really kinda tell. You go right into the very first one, and we wanna get now 7 in. So this is 1, and you just come in between the rows. There's 7 rows, so you can actually make it work. So this is 3, this is 4, 5, 6, and 7. So you're right on the other side again. And essentially just jump over again to the next one and do another 7, and just do this all the way across, and we'll meet back up on the other side and we'll keep on working on this motif. So now that we're all the way across, this one is unusual from the very first motif that you did that is the very biggest. And in fact the last motif, the biggest one, only has 2 rows going back and forth, and this one in fact has 3. So let's begin. We're gonna now chain up 1, and the first 5 are gonna be single crochets normal into it, and then the next 2 after that are gonna be the decrease. Okay, so let's do that. So we have in our 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so then the final 2 here are gonna be a decrease. So we're just wrapping through and hold, and wrapping through and hold, and then we'll continue to go the same pattern. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the next two are again a decrease. So wrapping through and wrapping through and pull through. Do that all the way across, making that pattern. The very last stitch that you have will be a decrease, and you can see this is starting to bend in a circle, which is the whole point of this round. And we'll carry on and move on to your very last round of doing the interior of the circle. So very simply, we've gone all the way across, and now I've turned my work now, and now we chain one. And this time we're just gonna do 4 single crochets in a row instead of 5. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then in the next two, we are gonna do a decrease. So wrapping through, hold, wrapping through and hold. And that will basically be the repeat pattern. So let's try this again. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the next two are together. So wrapping through, and do that all the way across. And your last one will be a together stitch. And basically I want you just to leave on the yarn. We'll meet back up because we need to sew this stuff together. So at this point we have what is looking like as a horseshoe here. And now it's time to put everything together by just doing some slip stitching right in the end. So if you look at between the petals here, you don't want to slip stitch it to the point where you have all the petals completely together just like so. You want to maintain this bending action just like you see. So just grabbing the other side of the ring, just grab the yarn and just pull it through, and we just want to slip stitch these stitches together. So just eye it up on both sides, put them together, grab the yarn, kind of pull through and through. And we just want to do it right until these lines stop. We don't want to go into any of the petal work in order to throw off our alignment of this piece of work. And you can just kind of fold them over top of each other really to give it indication, just making sure you're catching it just right like that. And so essentially you are now done, and you can just fasten off. So I'm just gonna pull up like this, and just using my crochet hook, I'm just gonna feed it through a few sections. I'm gonna bring it back to the top here because the top is gonna be sitting underneath the flower of another section, so you'll never really see it. So that's the advantage of it. So clean up your loose ends at this point. We still have one more section to do. If you notice the outside edges are looking pretty crude, and so in our next round, we're gonna soften those up by just doing a single crochet all the way around. So let's begin again. We want to do the single crochet edging, and this will soften up all the edges, and very easy. We just want to come in between the petals. We just want to come to the one side. We don't want to really want to come in down underneath right here. Just stay on the sides. We're only going to be working the sides and the tops of these petals. So just created a loop like so, letting the straggler fall. Chain one, and just single crochet into the stitches that you can get to on this side. You will see the stitch work. So you can just immediately go in. You don't need to do the trim to be the same color as your flower. You can do it something different if you wish. The creativity is really up to you. As you get to the tops, you just want to come in between the rows. Each row was a single crochet, and you can just safely come in between each of the rows just like you see coming over. And if you can't see that, just eye it up and make it look good. So coming in to the other side, you're gonna see stitches again, and you're gonna come all the way down to the bottom. Okay, we don't wanna come in and go into the bottom stitches here. We immediately wanna jump into the other side. Okay, so we don't wanna come down right to the bottom. And we just come back up the other side. So do this all the way around. It's just a very easy, painless process. You will find that if there's any imperfections in your petals at this point, this round will really kind of soften everything up and really bring it to a conclusion. So do that. We'll meet back up in a second when we're fastened off and call this motif done for today. Now I've come all the way back around, and now it's time to slip stitch in and just kind of bring everything to a conclusion. This is it for this particular motif. And this is the second one from the bottom. And very easy, very quick. When I go to fasten this off, I just wanna kind of weave in the edges really quite nicely so that they're not visible or they fall out. Especially if you're giving this for a gift, you can use a sewing needle or anything that you need to, in order to really safely hide in your ends. And voila, you are good to go. So this is the next size motif, just kind of quick and simple. It is, the next one is a lot more quicker because it is much smaller. And when you compare, so we have 1 and 2. This is the next one that is slightly smaller. You can see that everything is starting to come together quite beautifully.
So there you have it. You now have your finished motif and you just have one more to go in the very next video. So you can see in the next video that we're gonna have is that the petals are gonna be smaller and this is slightly smaller and gonna be sitting directly in front. So join me on video number 5 as we complete your last motif before we start assembling everything together. Until next time, on behalf of redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd, I'm your host Mikey joining you today. Until next time, see ya. And welcome back to redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. I'm your host Mikey here at the helm as we show you another crochet tutorial. This is video number 5 of 6 and today is the last motif in order to work on and to complete your spring fling pillow just like so. So in today's tutorial we are going to be working on the very last motif that exists just like so. It is the smallest one and it is the one where the center one will sit on top of just like so. So this is the very last one. This is a relatively quicker one to work on. There's less stitch work, it's not as big, and therefore it makes a lot of sense. So without further ado, let's get started on this fabulous tutorial. Thanks to redheart.com as well as the crochet crowd. So if you've been following me at all in the last few tutorials for this, you know that these are actually pretty simple and you know that at this point that the petals are very much like patio lanterns and we work, for example, we start working like this and we just keep going around and around. And so we eventually then come in to fill the center word afterward and then we sew it together and then just come around with the final edge. Now when you're working with these, the difference between the last two flower motif patterns that you had is that they are not as big. So when you're looking at these in comparison to the last ones here, you can see that they're a lot more shorter, so therefore there's a lot fewer stitches to work with when it comes to this particular pattern, and therefore this one is actually a relatively easy and quick and painless process. Now if you're just joining us for the very first time here, when we were working on these, the widths of all the petals that you had in the project are all identical, and in the center here between the white lines is row number 4. We have 3 and 5, and so basically the petals are essentially are reciprocal or opposite of each other. Once you get that middle one in there, everything you did on that side is done on the other, and it's just a very easy process to think about when you're thinking of it from that point of view. So let's now get started, and we are just going to be using some fabulous yarn, and in this time we are going to be using candy floss, and this is by Red Heart with Love, using a 5.0 millimeter Susan Bates crochet hook today. So let's begin. We're going to do a slip knot just like this, and essentially we want to only chain 3. So this one is a lot shorter. So 1, 2, and 3, and we come in second from the hook only. So this one's going to be nice and tight within your hands, and we just want to single crochet, and then we single crochet into the very last one. So there's only 2. So let's turn our material and we are going to chain 1. So the first one is going to get a single crochet, and the next one, the last one, is 2 single crochets. So if you understand what I said in the tutorial about, you know, one being easier to follow, when you were doing this one, the reason why the artist left it to the end is that once you understand what you're doing, you understand how these things are working, and it just makes it a lot easier and quicker. So let's chain 2. And we're going to come right underneath there and just do 2 half double crochets in. And then the final 2 is 2 single crochets. Okay, let's turn, chain 1. The first 2 are going to be 2 single crochets each. The last 2 are 2 half double crochets. This is row number 4. Turn, chain 2. 1 and 2, just like we've been doing on the other motifs, the first 2 are going to be condensed together. So wrap them through, leave it on the hook. These are half double decrease, and pull through all 5. And then the final 2 are single crochets each. Okay, turn, chain 1. First is a single crochet, and the next 2 are a decrease. So wrap them through, so it's a single crochet decrease, go through, turn, this is the final, chain 1, and the 2 single crochets only.
So this is petal number one. Very easy, very mindless really. So let's begin, and we're gonna start the next petal up, and the next petal up is gonna grow up on its side. So let's begin. So we're gonna chain three. 1, 2, 3. And the second from the hook is gonna be where you're gonna do the first single crochet in. And you're gonna do two single crochets in a row. So you have a total of two. So essentially at this point you have what looks like patio lanterns. You can untwist it as you're working your way across, and if you've been following the other tutorials that we've been working on, this is identical at this point in order to get your single crochets in across. So if you haven't joined us yet, basically what we're doing is that we're taking these petals here and we're creating the interior now, and we're usually what we do in crochet is that we work from the outside or inside going out. In this case we're working backwards and going inside. So let's begin this process, and now we have to chain up one, and in the first petal only we only need to get six single crochets between here and to where the next petal starts, and you can just simply just go between the rows and that works out the single crochet. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5 and 6. So there was 7 rows, so that worked in. So the chaining of one actually counts as 7. So if you're, so what we need to do is that we now need to get 7 single crochets in between this side and this side, and it works out. So we're just gonna come into the very first one in between the rows just like I said, and coming into the next one, and we just want a total of 7. So this is 3 going in, this is 4, and they're equally spaced, they're nice and flat. 5, 6, and 7. So continue to do that. Get your 7 double crochets in the top immediate, and once you get your 7 in, just immediately jump to the next one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And continue that, and I'll meet you back up in a second. We'll carry on finalizing this particular motif. So here we are at this point. We got our 7 across. You can see that you can bend it really easily, but it's not bending on its own. And now we're gonna start creating the bend automatically. So let's chain 1, and this is identical to what you've done in the other stitches. And the other stitches, what we did is that we did 5 single crochets in a row, and then we decreased for 1. So here we go. So 1, these are single crochets, 2, 3, 4. And 5, and in the next 2 are gonna be together. So single crochet together, wrapping through, hold, wrapping through, hold. Okay, so let's try it again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the next 2 are together, and you can see it's right on the very edge of that one. So wrapping through, and pull through all 3. So continue to do that all the way across. I'll meet you back up in just a second, and you can see that the bending is now starting to happen naturally, which is exactly what you're looking for. And we're back, and I just finished that round, and now we want to go, and you can see the bend is really now natural in comparison to what it was just a few seconds ago. So now we're gonna chain up 1, and this time we're gonna just go with 4 in a row. So single crochet for 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the next 2 are together, so it's the same thing. Single decrease, and keep doing that. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then decrease. And keep doing that all the way across. I'll meet you back up, and we got one more round to go, and then we're gonna do all the final touches. And finally, for your last row here on the interior, we are just gonna now chain up 1. And this time instead of doing 4, we're only doing 3. So we're just gonna single crochet 3 times in a row, and then the next 2 are together. So essentially 1 and 2. So again, 1, 2, and 3, and the next 2 are together. So continue that same process of going all the way across. Do not fasten off. We wanna just make sure we sew things together before we finish with that string, but we're almost done at this point. So at this point we have what looks like to be a horseshoe, and if you look at the original here, we now need to do it there. So we actually have a sewing line right where my thumb is over here, and essentially we need to do the same. So essentially I want you, when we put these together, we need to make sure that these petals are not interrupted. So when I go to sew these things together, is that I don't want the petals to naturally align. I only want to capture where it's going across in the rows that we did over the top of the petals. So I'm just gonna stick in my crochet hook into the top section of the other side to form this ring, and I'm gonna put my yarn over, and I'm just gonna pull it through to create a slip stitch. And essentially I just wanna come down only on the row section, go directly across to the other side, and just do a slip stitch. So pull through and through. And it keeps it nice and clean, so in, in the other side, pull through and through, and this will be my final one, and pull through and through like this. And so essentially then I have my sewing line just like so. This is a pretty well hidden behind the top layer. I would probably do a little bit of a nicer job but take my time at it, but I want to make sure that I'm doing it right as well. So I just want to pull through, and I want to kind of bring everything into conclusion. I want to bring the string back up to the top of the section here so that it is hidden underneath of the petal that sits over top of it. I used a sewing needle on my original pattern, just so you know, this crochet hook. It's an okay idea, but I think I just need a little more time on camera or off camera in order to perfect it to make it more of a nicer look to it, as you can see. So essentially the next one is just gonna sit directly over top. As you can see, it's hidden, but you know, I still wanna kinda take my time and make it look right. So what's wrong with this at this point? When you look at the two, the edging is not done yet when you look at this one here. So essentially we need to come back to this one and just finish it off with some nice edging, and we are good to go. To do the edging, all I wanna just do is just grab my crochet hook in, and I don't want to come right to the bottom of where two are joining. I just want to stick onto the sides only, just grabbing the loop, pulling it through, and I just want to get my straggler in the front there, and I want to chain one. So essentially all I'm just going to do is this, I'm going to work my way up the petal and down the other side. So when you're working up, there's only a couple stitches there before you're onto the areas of the rows. And so essentially these were only single crochet rows, so basically one single crochet in each row as you're going across the tops here is all that's necessary to go in. And you come back down the other row on this side of the petal, and we come back in, and we're in. So I never want to come down right where they're joining. I immediately want to jump over to the next one over here and just keep on going around and around. So I just go around once and I'll meet you back up. We're gonna fasten off and call this project done for today. Now once you're all the way back around, you simply just have to slip stitch to where you started and pull everything together just like so. And I wanna make sure that this loose end is really not visible. I just wanna kinda get it in nice and tight. And then what I wanna do is, normally I would weave along the edge of the flower, but then that's visible, so I'm gonna weave this in and out of the flower going toward the center underneath, and so, because you won't be able to see that as well. So just make it quite simple for you, and just quick and easy. Take your time, make it happen, no big deal, and voila, you're good to go. So just safely just come and trim in your ends, you are good to go, and at this point you are ready for the final video, which is the assembly video to put all of the components together. So that concludes this round, and again I would take my time more to not get that as I did in the original, is to be nice and flat by just using a sewing needle, or just taking my time to be a little bit nicer. And welcome back to redheart.com, as well as the crochet crowd. I'm your host Mikey here at the helm as we show you how to assemble your spring fling pillow. So if you've been following this series, you are now ready to put all of the six components together. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna be walking you through all of the procedures that you need to do in order to put your pillow together. So stay tuned and let's get started.
The next step we have is that we have the flat face, and we want to make sure the bumps are facing outward and the flat side is down. The flat side is the polyester of the stuffing. So now we want to grab our very largest petal, and mine happens to be green, and yours could be any color that you want. And what I want to just do now is just look down on top of it and kind of centerize it. I don't even know if that's a real word. But anyway, so what we have here is that you will have 7 petals, and so it's not a consistent thing. So you should not end up with a petal that's up here and then another one completely on the other side. Because there's 7, you will notice that it's kind of askew. And because we have multiple layers going down, it really isn't a big deal on trying to determine if the petal should be in a certain position. So just kind of just eye it out, make it look the best that you can. And certainly with your needle and using complementary colors that we've already done before, do the same technique of the slip stitch on the one side and the darning needle on the other. And essentially all we're just gonna do now is that we're just gonna go down on the stitches that are on the inside. And we're going down through the project and up. And the very first one I want to capture pretty close to the stitches. So right in, because what I want to do is I want to secure this very first piece in just like this. This will be buried underneath of the next petal. So usually you would come from the back end to start. You really don't have to at this point. So essentially I'm just going to work my way across. So just jumping down underneath the project and back up. And to finalize off, I'm essentially going to go down through the project and back up, and I want to insert the needle through the loop. I don't want to pull it all the way, but there will be a loop, and I want to do that twice. To really secure it into position. Just like so. And now I want to take the loose end, and I just want to drag it through some stitches. You can actually go into the inside of your work too, because you won't see that as well. But now that we've dragged it on the inside, grab your scissors and cut it, and we're going to start on with your next petal. And make sure you cut your loose end off as well. So there is step number 1 for attaching it to the pillow. The next step we have is that we want to place the next petal that is smaller to this. So we don't want the very smallest, we want the second size up. And you can really clearly tell when they're on top of each other which one is which. And essentially, again, it's 7 sides. So this time you want to make sure that the petals are falling in the middle of where the green ones were here. So yours could be a different color. But what I essentially want to do is that those stay in the middle of the petals that are underneath. And so you'll notice that the center point then falls into the green area here of the lime green and not the dark green. So then this will be attaching to the lime green area that's on the inside. Using the same technique of the slip stitch with the darning needle, we essentially just want to come down into the stitch just like we did with the green and just kind of fasten everything together. And we just want to make sure that this stays center as we start attaching it in. And we want to pull it through the slip stitch like we did before and just trap that straggler around as we go in. So just going in the next stitch just like so. We just want to make sure we're getting everything in, and just make sure you are double checking to ensure that this is staying centered and relative to the layer that's on the inside. I'm now coming back to where I started and essentially what I did before with the green, just coming down and in, and just want to make sure we want to just tie everything together. So don't pull the loop all the way through, just go through with the darning needle one more time and do that twice. So let's place and do the next layer just like so, and again it's 7 petals. So now this time I want it in between the last layer here. And just like so. And you will notice that the green layer is kind of like in a world on its own, and that's the wonderful thing about this layering effect is really quite amazing. Now you will notice that this ring almost matches the last ring that we put on the inside, so you can actually just look at it and just go down through that last petal, or you can go all the way down to the green. So essentially you're just going to start, pick a spot anywhere, and
I'm just gonna go down to the last layer that we just put on only. I'm not gonna go all the way down to the green. And I'm just gonna do the slip stitching effect like I did before and get that straggler ready, just like so. And just essentially just work my way around the ring, attaching this ring to the last ring. Try saying that 10 times fast. I'm now ready to finalize, so we're just gonna do the same thing that we did before, going in and just inserting the needle through the loop and doing that twice to tie it off. And then I wanna drag the straggler through the stitches in order to lose it into there so that you will never see it ever again. Okay, so the final layer that we have here is the centerpiece, and this essentially is just gonna go on the inside here. Again, I am looking for the petals, just like you see here. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and you remember you got 7 petals here, so I'm just kind of making it look good, whatever you want. So what I'm sewing with this one, I wanna come in at the seam line of where I've changed color on the inside here. So I'm just gonna essentially make sure that it's sitting down. Because I have stuffed the inside, the inside is gonna pop quite amazingly. But if you didn't wanna have the stuffing there, you can see that if you did that, you could have a centerpiece like that as well. So that's something that's pretty well up to you when it comes to your creativity. And now that I see this coming together, I actually might go back in afterward and really thinking that that puff may actually not be the best thing for me, that I might actually just go in and seal that down so that it stays nice and sunk in. So that's something that, you know, as creativity, you can think about stuff to do for yourself. So let's get started, and we're just gonna come in. I'm just gonna peel back the layer that you see right in there, and I'm using the same color that is these petals, and that's where I wanna stay in the project. And when you peel back, you will notice that you're gonna be in line with the last one that is underneath, and so we can just safely just attach it to there. This one is gonna take a little more time to be a little more conscientious of where your stitches are coming back in and out, and I just wanna make sure that I'm just gonna grab it through the slip stitch to really hold it in. Because I've used it variegated yarn, it's very easy to hide any kind of imperfections that you may find. And again, I'm just peeling back the layer. I'm just grabbing the one that is underneath directly. I'm not going all the way down into this particular project. And I wanna make sure that that straggler is getting trapped as well as we go and coming back out through here. So do that all the way around. Just stick within that color so that you will never see any of this stitch work as you're going all the way around. So essentially don't go into that middle color with a different one if you're not interested in that particular effect. So I'm essentially coming to the end, and how I know is that when I put my finger behind, I can't peel it back any longer. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna finish this on the underside of this petal so that when this sits back down, you won't even see this as well. So I'm just gonna do that tying effect like I did. So pull through a loop, do that twice. And all I'm just gonna do now is feed the stitches, and I'm going completely underneath the flower at this point. I just wanna stay out of the green on the top surface here, and I just wanna drag things over so I can safely now cut. And this is the straggler that we started off with, and I can safely cut that. So then my next step here is that I'm gonna actually fasten this down immediately to the middle here as my next step. This is something that I'm just gonna decide for myself. Again, I just wanna figure out, you know, I think it looks good as being sunk down just like so. Okay, for the middle section here, I wanna tack it down, but I wanna come from this time I wanna come it from the back. So essentially, I'm just gonna stick in my needle from behind. I just happened to get the center point. The chances of that happening are quite amazing. But essentially, I wanna come in the front and immediately back down. So just jam it down. I'm not going through the very center point of the middle here. And essentially I'm just gonna turn it over at this point, just pull everything through and through the slip stitch, just like we have been doing. So at this point, all I'm just doing, this is a lot of string, but essentially I just wanna make sure that I'm coming in around and I just wanna tack it so that it is gonna sink and it's gonna stay sunk. So I'm just coming up somewhere else. And because I'm using the same color, you really can hide this very well. And just turning it over. I just kind of eyeing it through the back, see where it's coming out at the front. And then down. So I just want to do this just, I've actually already gone all the way around at this point. So at the back here, I'm just going to come up underneath the stitch and pull through a loop and do that twice. So now essentially the front part, this is on the back, so I can leave a little bit of extra if I want to. So essentially now the front part has permanently been sunk down so that even no matter what you do, this will never pop up. You can actually use a button in the middle of this too if you wanted to as well. So let's move on to our next step. So our very next step now is to attach the one face to the other. So essentially, remember what I said in the very beginning is that you have two sides, you have a flat side and you have a bumpy side. So the bumpy side is facing out and that's why we have the flower there. And so basically I want to look at the stitch work and essentially I don't want to do this. You can see that the bumps are going in this direction on the flower. I want to make sure that it's matching each other. So all I'm just going to do, pay attention, turn it over and just have the stitch work match. So I'm just going to essentially start putting three sides together in order to make a pocket. So I'm just going to start on the one side. It doesn't matter which side you start on. Going into the corner, like so, a corner, and you essentially just want to match the stitch work as you're going down through the edges. So just pulling it through. If I didn't have a generous amount of string on here, so if I run out of string at any point, I could just add more. And again, with the sewing technique of the straggler, I've gotten to the first stitch. I want to now move down to the second, and I just want to keep it everything pinched together so that the stragglers are getting trapped into position. And I'm just going to be very nice and tight with this idea. As we're going all the way around, we are using polyester stuffing when we go to stuff this. So when I go to stuff it, I'm going to judge at that point because I don't want the point of the pillow to be stuffed to the point where it's like blowing up and the stuffing is falling out of the stitches. So it's something that you can judge afterward. So essentially just match stitch to stitch, going just three sides only, and then we're going to stuff it and put everything together and then essentially just sew the final edge and the spring fling pillow is good to go. So now we're ready to do the stuffing part of it, and at this point you have three sides sewed together and now you have a gorgeous little pocket on the inside. And now it's time to get your polyester stuffing and just stuff it on the inside. So the whole key to doing the stuffing is that you don't want it to the point where it's puffing out to the point where you are seeing your the stuffing coming through the outside, just like so. So I'm just kind of being generous with it, kind of compacting it, but being conscientious that it's not enough. This polyester stuffing goes a long way, so it's a great little to have in your inventory for projects in the future. And one thing I noticed about stuffing is that you don't want it to the point where it's all balled up in one area as well. So you want to make sure you're kind of just stuffing it around. And I think that's kind of nice, just like so. And I don't see my stuffing coming through anywhere, so I think at this point it's safe now to sew across the last line here. So let's put the stuffing down, grabbing your needle and your yarn, same technique as you've been using at this point, and essentially just coming down across the final edge, just matching the seams to the seam, just like this. Drag it through your slip stitch or slip knot. And again, with the straggler, just leave it down and just match the stitch to stitch as you're going all the way across.